Now let us look at the question number 10 here, and this is again one of the easiest question because they are directly asking about the time complexity or the space complexity. They are saying consider the following terminologies and the match the list 1 and list 2 and choose the correct answer from the code given below. So B represents the branching factor, D is the depth of the shallowest solution, M is the maximum depth of the search tree, and L, or you can say this L is representing the depth limit. So generally, for example, this is representing a tree. Now you can see this is a ternary tree, right? So in this tree, if you see what is the branching factor here, branching factor is 3. Why? Because every node is having 3 children. And the depth of the shallowest solution. So what is the shallowest solution, or you can say shallowest node here? So you can see from here, I can go till here. So this is the depth of the shallowest solution. And this is also the maximum depth of the search tree here in this case. But again, in some different graph, this and this, they can be different. We have to draw a different graph for this. And then we have the depth limit. So what is the depth limit? So maximum how much depth you are allowed to take. Now here they are giving an algorithm which is BFS, DFS, depth limited search and iterative deepening. And they are asking what is the space complexity for all of them. And it's a very straightforward question. If you have studied some of these algorithms, then you should know what is the space complexity. So in case of breadth first search, the space complexity of breadth first search is order of V, that is the number of vertices, and which can also be written as order of B raised to power D. Because in case of breadth first search, you traverse according to the breadth and you take a queue here in this case, and you take all the adjacent vertices in the queue. Now, again, then we have the next one is your depth first search. In case of depth first search, if I just give in terms of vertices, then it is order of V, right? So V is the number of vertices, but again, this is also representing the longest path. So longest path from root to node. For example, here, this is the tree. Now here the longest path is like this, right? So here the depth is order of V. But if we just give in terms of B, that is the branching factor, E, that is the depth. So the time complexity here is order of B into D. So this is the basic difference between DFS and BFS here, which is according to the space complexity of these two operations, these two algorithms. Totally depends of how these algorithms are working. So in case of DFS, it is B into D. But then when we come about this iterative deepening, in this case, it is order of D only. So out of these four, we know for three, therefore we'll be able to solve it, right? So here for breadth first search, BFS, the correct answer is B raised to power D, that is 2. And for DFS, the correct answer is 1. So let us check how many options can we eliminate. So we can eliminate the option number 1 here, because here this is wrong. Then in option number 2, we have 1 and both of them are giving correct, right? For A, they are giving 1, so this is wrong. So let us look at the other options here. Then we have in option number 3, they are giving for option number A, we have 2 correct. For option number B, we have 3. So for option number B, we have option number 3. Actually, this is for the shallowest solution, and okay. So again, this option number 3 and 4, we can check. For option number 3, A is 2, that is correct, and for B is 3. So for B, we are getting 3, that is also okay, because here M is representing the maximum depth of the search tree. So here when I've written this, so here D was representing the maximum depth of the search tree, because we go till the maximum depth. Therefore, I can just correct it up here. So if I just correct it up for option number B, I can also write this one, fine. And then we have iterative deepening. Iterative deepening is order of D, where D is representing the depth, that is the maximum depth, right? So here, this depth limited search is means that we are going to go till a certain depth only. And then for option number C, I think the correct answer should be option number 4 and option number D, the correct answer should be this one. Okay, so this is the correct answer. So if you just match the options, so 1 and 2 they are wrong. Option number 4 is also wrong, because for A the correct answer is 2, and the correct answer is option number 3 here. That is the correct answer. So for this question number 10, the correct answer is option number C. I hope you got it, because this is very straightforward question. Because you should know the time complexity of these solutions.